One particular night, I was craving a good movie, and with movies, popcorn is always in order. So I decided to watch, by the pricking of my thumbs, an Agatha Christie mystery. Jacket of my dreams. Looking on the web at Pinterest, I found a picture of the costume. There are a few changes I think that I'll make in this design. I have a wonderful piece of vintage fabric from the 80s. It was given to me, and not something I would normally choose, but I've been quite intrigued with it for a long time. The wool I'm going to use is a bit heavier, so for warmth, I think I'll make the jacket a bit longer. Also, instead of armhole princess seams, I'm going to use side bust darts and fisheye darts. This gray, black, and white plaid is just beautiful, and I have black velvet to go with it. I love matching plaids and tartans. To make the pattern, I'll use my personal torso sloper, the pattern for the sloper, and the muslin torso sloper to check the fit. This sloper is a very good fit. It's not too tight. The darts are in the right place. The grain lines across the bust and the waist are in the right place. The shoulder darts are in the middle of the shoulder, and there's plenty of room in the body. I think this could be just perfect for this jacket. My sloper has a mid-shoulder dart. The fabric that I'm going to use has a directional pattern to it, and a mid-shoulder dart would disrupt that pattern. So I'm shifting the dart to be a side bust dart. Once the pattern is completed, I'll make a prototype, and I happen to have some cream-colored wool that has a few moth holes, so it won't be used for anything else. I make sure to block the fabric and draw all the grain lines, placing the paper pattern on top of the wool. Everything will align. checking the fit of the prototype, the shoulder width is good, the sleeves are in a perfect place, as are the darts, and there seems to be enough room for a woolen jacket. The elbow line is a little bit low, so I can change that in the pattern. The darts in the back from the waist down seem to be short. There's too much room across that area, so I'll have to extend the darts a little bit. Other than that, I think it's a pretty good fit. Now to work with the plaid. What I'm going to do is look at the vertical and the horizontal lines and determine where I want the center front and where I want the apex, the fullest part of the bust, to fall. Once I determine that, I will put a safety pin at the center front line and at the apex. Determining this mark will help me start the pattern placement on the plaid. The center front and apex line on the pattern will match where the safety pin has been placed. I've basted grain lines for center front and the waistline, and there is my apex. The yellow basting on the plaid fabric represents where I want the waistline to be. By aligning the waistline of the pattern, both front and back pieces, along that yellow line, I'll be able to match the plaid perfectly. Thank you. so that the plaid of the sleeve blends in and matches the plaid in the front body, I align the fabric at mid-armhole. I need to ignore the seam allowance and make sure that at mid-armhole where the notch is, in the fabric only, not the seam allowance, the two match.
Thank you.
This jacket would be fun to wear in Paris. Maybe to a cafe and have a cappuccino. Thank you for joining me. I hope you've enjoyed this video as much as I have enjoyed making it. See you next time.